Welcome back to the High Performance Build. Today, we're about to pour the slab in the conditioned crawl space. This is a totally conditioned, basically just think of it as a tiny basement. The reason it's here is because I want access to my services. I want access to run more wires and to modify the house down the line. And I don't want to bury stuff in concrete. So this is going to have 2 inches of concrete over the top of this Pango Wrap vapor and termite barrier. And this is what we're going to really talk about today. This stuff is very, very important. Number one, Stego Industries makes a whole bunch of different types of vapor barriers. This is a 15 mil vapor barrier, which is one of the thicker ones that you would install in a crawl space application. It's gonna go right underneath the concrete. We're gonna pour the concrete literally right on top of this. It comes folded up, which I appreciate because these edges are what you're gonna be taping. And instead of you having to clean them off so that you can apply the tape on the seams, you just unfold it, and the idea is, if you haven't messed with it too much, it's nice and clean on the face that you're trying to tape. Also, this is termite proof. They have tested it so that subterranean termites don't eat up through it, and that goes for the tape as well, which is really important. They've got a couple different ways to attach it. We're not applying it to any wet concrete. You could use Pango cloth for that, but we're not going to be doing that. Instead, we're just attaching this directly to the foundation wall with a 2-inch Pango tack tape. And so this basically is made for attaching this membrane to smooth concrete, which we have at the bottom 2 inches of the foundation wall. So essentially, we're just going to put this on, peel off one of the layers to attach it to the wall, and then wait until we're ready to attach this. We've already rolled this out and cut it to fit, and then peel off the second layer and attach the Pango wrap to that. This I was really excited about just because I like it when materials do more than one thing. This is gonna give us a layer of air tightness on top of the vapor and termite tightness, which is gonna enable me to suck on the subslab with my radon mitigation system and not have radon coming up through the slab. Now that suction is important. I wouldn't just leave it as a passive system or with no suction at all. Anything that can go wrong will go wrong, right? Of course. So we're just trying to make sure that we have not only an enclosure that is perfect, ideally, but if that ever goes wrong, we also have an engine that will, whose job it is to modify and correct for anything that we don't want coming into the house. Done. We poured this morning. You know it's going to be a special day when you wake up after you're supposed to be awake. The sun is already well up into the air. The first word out of your mouth is a swear word. You stumble through your 200 square foot house and out the door, and you see the boom truck already there waiting for you to move your pickup truck so that they can park. So we scrambled for a little while just trying to finish up all of the taping because, of course, it's very cold out here. Now, one of the things that I'll just mention is with the Pango Wrap system, the tape is not supposed to be used under 40 degrees, whether the surface temperature of the concrete needs to be 40 degrees or more. The air temperature needs to be 40 degrees or more. You can spend all your time with a heat gun and a space heater out here, but honestly, you're not gonna fight the weather very well. So performance is hard, and we worked really hard. I was here last night until there was literally ice forming on the top of the Pango wrap. And then we woke up this morning and worked with a slightly different tape, and that works down to 0 degrees Fahrenheit. So that came in handy. That was really nice. I think that all tape should work down to negative 50 degrees if possible. Chemists, do your thing. Please comment, like, subscribe if you've used this stuff before, or if you have anything to say about termite control or vapor control in general, feel free to start a conversation. I look at and try to respond to all the comments. And this is part of a long series on the build of this house, which again is my family's house, and I am the builder of this. So please do stay tuned for watching our mistakes and our successes in this whole thing. I'll see you next time.